Greetings. Today's talk focuses on the power to weight ratio for the Model 3, and might it become a Model S killer? Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch im Ausbeinen? Ni hao ma strazvice. Guten Tag. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. I've been doing some research on the Model 3, given that we're a month away from production starting and deliveries starting to occur. And one of the things that popped up in the news was the fact that Model S sales are down, and there's a lot of inventory of those vehicles now available. So I started looking at, you know, what was going on with this. And one of the things I learned about is that the average Model S weighs approximately 5,000 pounds. And the speculation right now, based on a smaller car as well as less battery weight, is that the Model 3 is going to come in somewhere in the 3,700 pound arena, possibly 4,000. So it's going to weigh 25% less. And then I know there's some creative folks that are looking for performance that might pull out the back seat and possibly put in some racing seats for the passenger and driver. And so if you could cut 1,500 to 1,800 pounds off the car, you now have a car that has a smaller battery pack, but also carries heading for half the weight. And so when you have this combination, you have what's called an excellent power to weight ratio. Now, based on the folks that are on my page and the responses I get, I know the engineer in you will help us in doing the calculation, but I think there's a possibility that you could have a $35,000 car blowing the doors off your $100,000 Model S. So the reasons why, you know, heavy sales and demand for the Model 3 are there are clear. More people can afford $35,000 than they can a $100,000 vehicle. So that's valid. The next issue that's popping up is, could the Model 3 end up destroying Model S sales because you're getting a better balance of power to weight, and therefore you may have a better performing vehicle in the 3, even though you don't get the luxury appointments and long wheelbase that goes for the Model S. I should say, don't cry for Tesla should Model S sales slow down because of the Model 3, because right now there is crazy demand for the battery packs in the form of trucks and other products for Tesla. So they can easily weather the storm of a Model 3 taking off as it hits the marketplace. So I think this is, it's definitely worth noting. I believe that the other interesting thing that's going on is the possibility of repurposing battery packs. So if sales really got bad for the Model S, one could theoretically shift those battery packs to other areas where there's heavy demand and huge shortages going on. So it's, I think, a pain in the neck for Tesla to sell more Model 3s to get the same revenue that they do off of Model S. But I think right now they have an embarrassment of riches. Demand from a number of places for the use of their battery packs. And also, let's remember that the Model 3's engine components are being used in their truck products as well. So Tesla has an embarrassment of riches. And this will be interesting to find out if the Model 3 truly can defeat the larger engine Model S. Thanks for taking time out to watch. Look forward to my engineer responses regarding this power to rate ratio advantage that the Model 3 may have. Please subscribe and like. Tschüss, mach's gut. Au revoir, la hitra haute. Hoda Hafez. Ciao. Ciao. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight.